Our huge Halloween flash sale actually starts tomorrow, Thursday, October 28th at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. And one of the biggest flashlights for that sale is the brand new 2,300 lumen Warrior 3. This is an awesome upgrade to the previous M2R Pro, which is easily one of our most popular tactical flashlights that we offer. So in this video, we're actually going to compare all of the improvements and new features of the Warrior 3 compared to the previous version, which is the M2R Pro.
Now, before we dive in to show you the upgrades compared to some of the other lights, it only makes sense to give one of these away. All you guys need to do to enter is subscribe to this channel, like this video, and leave us a comment below on what your favorite feature of the Warrior 3 is, and you'll be able to win one in the color of your choice.
Now, the Warrior 3 is easily one of the most feature-packed flashlights that we have ever made. It includes so many Olight features that we've been working hard on and something that differentiates us from the competition. So with that said, let's go ahead and talk about all the awesome features of the Warrior 3 compared to some previous lights. Now for this comparison video, we've decided to compare the new Warrior 3 to not only the M2R Pro, but also the full-size Odin, because it is actually very similar in terms of specifications, and also considering that the Warrior 3 also works with our lock-on remote switch, it makes sense because you may be deciding between the Warrior 3 and the Odin to put on your rifle. Now with that said, let's start with the lumens of all of these. Now for the Warrior 3, it has an incredible 2,300 lumens. Now this is the newest flashlight that we've come out with, so obviously it should have the most lumens out of these three. But when we compare it, the Odin right here has 2,000 lumens, and the previous M2R Pro has 1,800 lumens. So it's got 300 more lumens than the Odin, and 500 more lumens than the M2R Pro. That is a significant upgrade considering that all of these flashlights are very similar in size. Now what's really interesting is that when we look at the beam distance, it's actually the same on all of these. Now some really important factors for beam distance is the diameter of the head and the length of the reflector. Considering that all of these lights have very similar diameters, it makes sense that we couldn't change the beam distance of the Warrior 3 that much, considering that it's really defined by the actual size of the head of the light and not just the LED and the circuitry. So again, they all have a 300 meter beam distance. So if you're worried about beam distance, just know that it's all the same with all three of these. Now we're standing in the same studio that we were at before, but all of the lights are off, and I'm going to shine the flashlights at that black wall that we've been standing in front of. Now let's go ahead and first shine the full-sized Odin. And here it is right there. And I do actually have the camera on manual mode, so there shouldn't be any kind of auto adjust with what it looks like. Now it is probably gonna freak the camera out a little bit, but hopefully on this manual mode, it'll give you a good idea of what it looks like. So as you can see, you got a nice defined center hotspot right there, and you have some surrounding light there with that spill. It is a really nice looking hotspot. It isn't an oblong shape or something strange like that. You're getting some real nice intensity right there, and the spill is very clean. Now let's go ahead and jump over to the M2R Pro, and I'll show this to you here. So here's the M2R Pro. So you're getting a little bit smaller of a hotspot, a little bit more of a cool white beam on this one. And also that spill is actually a little bit less looking than the Odin. So just keep that in mind, that maybe a little bit larger hotspot with the Odin, a little bit more spill, but that kind of makes sense considering that the M2R Pro is 1800 lumens and the Odin is 2000 lumens. So it makes sense to have a little bit larger hotspot, a little bit more spill with that higher intensity at this close-up wall. Now let's go ahead and jump over to the Warrior 3 and give you an idea of that.
Warrior 3 is going to be a lot more cool white than the other previous two. You're getting the coolest beam with this Warrior 3. But as you can see, again, beautiful hotspot here, guys. Perfect shape. There's nothing strange going on here, and I'm glad to see that it's a nice, clean, cool white. I think we're getting the most spill right here as well. Here in person, I'm able to see the sides of this room a lot better with this Warrior 3 compared to the Odin and the M2R Pro. So there's definitely significantly more spill coming from that hotspot with the Warrior 3. And I think the hotspot itself is the cleanest with this Warrior 3 as well. So I would say, based on this comparison and just shining them at this wall, you're getting the most refined beam and probably the most useful beam here with the Warrior 3.
Now, when we compare the max run times of all three of these, the M2R Pro and the Warrior 3 are pretty similar. So the M2R Pro at the 1 lumen moonlight setting has a 50-day runtime, which really is incredible. But for pretty much the same battery and same size on the Warrior 3, it has a 55-day runtime at that 1 lumen setting. So that's some really nice efficiency right there, guys. That's an extra 5 full days of runtime on that 1 lumen moonlight mode coming from the Warrior 3. Now, if we bring in the Odin really isn't even a part of this because this is strictly a rifle light. It's a very simple tactical light. It only has 2 different settings. So on this one, you have that 2000 lumen high setting like what we talked about before, and it has a 300 lumen low setting, which lasts for 8 hours. So obviously this isn't even a part of the moonlight setting conversation with the Warrior 3 and the M2R Pro, but it was worth mentioning.
Now, like we mentioned, the Odin only has a low and a high mode, but the M2R Pro and the Warrior 3 have so many more settings. The M2R Pro has 6 modes plus strobe for a total of 7, and the Warrior 3 has 5 modes plus strobe for a total of 6. The M2R Pro has a 750 lumen setting, which is going to run for 160 minutes, compared to an 800 lumen setting that's going to run for 166 minutes. So you're not compromising any kind of performance there.
So that means on the high mode with the Warrior 3, you're actually getting 50 more lumens with the 800 versus the 750, but you're getting 6 more minutes of runtime. So you're getting a brighter high mode for a longer period of time. Really nice on that high mode, and especially at 800 lumens, that's a super useful setting that I'm sure you'll be using frequently.
Now, as we continue to go through the settings, like I said, the M2R Pro actually does have one additional setting that the Warrior 3 doesn't, and that's 250 lumens that's going to run for 10 hours. Now, as I continue to go through the last couple settings of each light, you'll see where the Warrior 3 actually makes up for that. So now that we're gonna go back head to head here, the next lowest setting on the M2R Pro is 60 lumens, which is actually going to run for 40 hours, but the Warrior 3 has a 200 lumen setting that's gonna run for 13 hours.
So with the Warrior 3, you are losing out on that 60 lumen setting, but being able to have that 200 lumens for 13 hours versus the 250 lumens for only 10 hours on the M2R Pro, I think is a nice compromise. That 200 lumen setting, something again that you're probably going to use fairly often. That's a really nice lumen level for most tasks, and to have that for 13 hours is legit. Now the low mode on the Warrior 3 and the M2R Pro is exactly the same. They both have 15 lumens and they both run for 130 hours. So fantastic run times on both, and I'm glad to see that that exact same setting is on the Warrior 3. And then after that, we have the moonlight setting, which we've already talked about, which is 55 days on the Warrior 3 and it's 50 days on the M2R Pro. So there is your differences in lumen levels between each light. I think there are pros and cons to each, but I am happy with the increase in run times with the Warrior 3 on its settings versus the M2R Pro.
Now I have them on the table here like this because I first wanted to show you the length difference like what we talked about earlier. So the Warrior 3 has a 5.47 inch length and the M2R Pro here on the top is 5.37 inches and you can see I've got them butt to butt right here and you can see that size difference there at the head pretty well in this orientation. You can also see that the actual camouflage on both of these is completely different. Now, please keep in mind that the M2R Pro is not available in the camo finish any longer. It was a limited edition and we are sold out, but I wanted to show it to you compared to the current Warrior 3 that will be available during the sale in this desert camo right here. Now, the same way with both of these is how you can put the clips on here, and they actually feature pretty much the same clips. So you've got that dual direction clip, so you can put it bezel down or bezel up in your pocket, and you also can actually physically put the clip on two different sections of the flashlight. So let me show you here. I have the Warrior 3, and I'm going to just simply pull the clip off right here from the head, and I'm going to put it here at the tail, just like how it is on this M2R Pro back here. So you've got really four different ways that you can carry the M2R Pro and the Warrior 3 with that dual direction clip. The next major physical difference that I want to show you is the side switch. Now, as you can see, they look completely different because they are. So you can see here that the actual diameter of the switch is much larger on the Warrior 3 compared to the M2R Pro. Not only with the actual button itself, but with the bezel surrounding the button itself. Because the Warrior 3 right here actually has these indicators on each side of it, which is something that I'm really happy to see because we've never actually had this feature in a tactical flashlight before. The only lights that we've actually ever done it with is the Seeker 2 Pro, the Seeker 3 Pro, the X9R, and the Marauder 2. So it's really nice to see this feature finally on a different line of products that we offer. Now, as you can see, the right side right there is gonna show you your battery level, and it's four LEDs, so it's gonna be in 25% increments. So you have 25, 50, 75, and 100% of battery. So depending on what LED shows up when you turn your flashlight on, that's where your battery level is on the flashlight. It's very easy to understand and remember that. Now, for the lumen levels on the left side, it's going to go through your main lumen levels. Let's go ahead and turn it on here by holding it down, and that'll take you to the one lumen moonlight setting, which is that 55 days like we talked about before. Now, if I hold it down again, you're still going to see only that one LED, but that's going to bring you up to that 15 lumen setting. Now, if I hold it down one more time, that's going to take you to two LEDs, which will be that 200 lumen setting. Now, if I hold it down again, it's going to be that 800 lumen setting. And then if I do a double tap to go all the way to turbo, it's going to be that 2300 lumen setting. So with the first LED indicator, you're getting one lumen in 15, then you get 200, then you get 800, and that 2300. Now with the M2R Pro, well, it doesn't do any of that. All it's going to do is show you your battery indicator in the center of that side switch. And right now it's green because this is fully charged, but if it was around 50%, you would see it be a yellow color. And then if it's around 10%, you would see it be a red color. And that's pretty much the only thing that this side switch can do other than change through the settings by holding the switch down. Okay, and then you can double tap to get to turbo as well. So obviously there's a lot more going on with this side switch in terms of not only the size of it making it easier to press, but you're getting way more indicators so you know what's going on with your flashlight a lot better. I find this to be a way bigger improvement compared to really anything else on the flashlight compared to the M2R Pro. Now, another major difference I want to show you guys is the tail cap. Now, for the tail switch, they are both that stainless steel tail switch that is magnetic, and you can charge it magnetically with the chargers that we offer and that come with these flashlights. But the biggest difference is the fact that with the Warrior 3, you can actually use our lock-on remote switch similar to the Odin. So as you can see, if you're looking at the tail cap of the M2R Pro, it's just smooth and rounded off, and then you get to the stainless steel switch. Now, when you take a look at it here on the Warrior 3, you can see there's this whole different section right there, and then you get to the metal tail switch. So if you're just using the flashlight with your thumb, it's going to be a very similar experience, but it's really awesome that it's also compatible with our remote switch. Check this out. I'm going to put that on there, and then I'll be able to lock it down so you can't pull it off. Now, I'm not sure if it'll even work. No, look, see, it won't even actually click onto it properly. But the fact that now you can actually lock it on with the Warrior 3 makes it a game changer. Now it's going to have the same functionality as the Odin when you have it on your rifle and be just as reliable under recoil. Now, since we're already on the topic of remote switches, the Warrior 3, like I said, does have the lock-on remote switch capability, which is the same as the Odin, but it actually has a major advantage over the Odin, and that is it's actually compatible with our brand new dual button remote switch. So you're able to not only access turbo mode with that switch, but you're able to access low as well. So you can see that on the side switch there, it's showing two LEDs when I press it. Two LEDs is going to take you up to 200 lumens. So you have access to 200 lumens with a small button. And then when you hit the large button, that's going to take you to the four LEDs on the side switch. So obviously that is turbo, which is 2300 lumens. So you got a low and a high with that lock-on remote switch. Now, what's interesting is this dual button remote switch isn't even compatible with the Odin. So with the Odin, yes, you can still lock it on, but it's only going to have that turbo one button remote switch. So this is the only way that you can use it with the Odin. Whereas again, on the Warrior 3, you have the low and the high with the remote switch. Really nice addition right there. Now let's talk about mounting these on a rifle, and it's drastically different. So with the new Warrior 3, the way you're going to do it, since this is just a normal handheld light, is you're going to pull the clip off, okay? You're going to go ahead and remove the tail cap. Then what you're going to do is take your EWM25, and we're basically going to slide it through the mount just like that. And then we're going to put the tail cap back on. And then you're going to put it on the top of your Picatinny rail or on the side as you see fit. And then of course, from there, you'll go ahead and attach your remote switch. And that is going to be your setup on the rifle with your Warrior 3. Now, with the Odin, it is completely different since this is a dedicated rifle light. With this one, we actually have a Picatinny rail mount that slides on and locks just like that. Also, for the Odin series, it doesn't come with the full-size Odin, but we also have it where it works with an M-lock mount as well. So there is a little bit more functionality in terms of mounting the Odin, because we not only have the Picatinny, but we also have the M-lock. But the only thing is, with the Odin, the only way that you can transfer to it being a handheld light is if you get our finger grip ring and mount that to the side right there. But this is a little bit odd to have in your pocket. So I wouldn't say that this is really an EDC pocket flashlight, whereas the Warrior 3 actually is, once you remove the remote switch and the mount and put the pocket clip back on. So yes, the Odin does have a couple advantages when it comes to mounting with those additional mounts, but it's really awesome that you can take the Warrior 3 off of your rifle and throw it in your pocket, and it's a comfortable everyday carry pocket flashlight.
Guys, thank you so much for checking out this overview of the comparison between the brand new Warrior 3, the M2R Pro, and the full-size Odin.
So at the end of the day, we took honestly some of the best Olight features that we offer with any of the products on our line and put them all into one. Again, like what I was saying, you have the remote switch compatibility of our Odin series. You also have the side switch of the Seeker 2 Pro, and you're also getting all of the awesome features that we include with pretty much all of our tactical tail switch pocket lights. So it really is a fantastic product, and I'm glad to see it come to fruition. Now, the coolest part about all of this is the fact that you can get up to 40% off the new Warrior 3 in three colors right off of the initial release. So we have this really great looking camo. We also have black And we have the limited edition orange version here for our Halloween sale. Again, the sale starts tomorrow, Thursday, October 28th at 8 p.m. Eastern time, and it goes all the way until Friday night at midnight Eastern time. So you only have 28 hours to score a deal on these, but I would highly suggest picking them up at that 40% off deal before the price goes way up after the sale.
Now, if you want to check out all of the awesome deals on the Warrior 3 and so much more for our Halloween sale, head to the link in the description below. But before you guys do that, don't forget we're giving away a Warrior 3 in the color of your choice in this video. All you need to do to enter is subscribe to this channel, like this video, and leave us a comment below on your favorite feature of the brand new Warrior 3.
Like she said, we not only have the Warrior 3 up to 40% off, but we have so much more on sale too. There are so many products in this sale, and you can get some screaming deals, some of the best deals of the year on Olight products. Again, the link is in the description of this video. Click that and check everything out and get ready to put those orders in tomorrow, Thursday night at 8 p.m. Eastern time. Thank you so much for checking out this comparison video between the Warrior 3, Odin, and M2R Pro. We'll see you guys on the next video. Peace.